State legislative session wrapped up just about 12 hours ago. It was a race to the end with another night of rising tensions. Well, the tensions came as the deadline to pass bills ended after hours of filibuster. Michelle Beck shows us what was passed and what was left behind.
It was a wild end to the legislative session. A lot of consequential outcomes, also a lack thereof. First, no public works construction bonding bills were passed. Despite the House passing it with just 10 minutes to spare, it was rushed to the Senate and their vote came seconds past midnight. What else didn't pass? The Equal Rights Amendment and sports betting bills. Some wins, though, for House Democrats is the tax bill that included eight other ones that had been tabled over the last week. They include the bill about paid leave and higher penalty for straw firearms, the tax bill itself, including advanced payments of the child tax credit.
The voice of the minority was completely shut out during the end process. We were asking to be recognized. We were asking for the bill.
When you refer to people with different opinions than you as people who are bad people or stupid, we definitely did hear a lot of that over the last 3 weeks. It makes it harder to bridge the differences.
And in a step forward to keep Uber and Lyft drivers in Minnesota, a plan for statewide standards on drivers' pay now goes to the governor. At the state capitol, Michelle Beck, KARE 11 News.
Michelle, thank you. Developing overseas, there's now an interim president in Iran after a helicopter crash killed President Raisi. His death furthering adding to the instability in the Middle East. Let's go to NBC's KARE Simmons reporting from the Gulf region.
Well, governments across the Middle East, including here in the Gulf, are watching and worrying about events in Iran this morning with that news that President Raisi did die in that helicopter crash. An Iranian official describing it as a hard landing last night before the news of the fatalities emerged and saying it was due to fog and bad weather. And certainly the images of the frantic hours-long rescue operation in Iran on the border with Azerbaijan do show thick fog and mountainous terrain. Now Iran is in mourning. The first vice president has taken over. He is almost as much a hardliner as President Raisi was. He went to Russia to do a deal over weapons back in October. President Raisi presided over a government that sent missiles towards Israel, an historic move just last month, over a government that crushed protests over women's rights after the death of a 22-year-old woman. So there will be many around the world who will not mourn him, many others, though, sending their condolences, including President Putin of Russia and President Xi of China. Where this goes now in a region so marked by instability is a question many people in many capitals will be asking today.
KARE, thank you. And condolences are coming from Iran for Iran, including from Hamas, which released a statement calling the crash an unfortunate accident and painful tragedy. Meanwhile, the chief prosecutor of the International Criminal Court said today he's seeking arrest warrants for Hamas and Israeli leaders, including Prime Minister Netanyahu, accusing them of war crimes and crimes against humanity in their seven-month war. WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange will get another chance to avoid extradition to the U.S. The High Court in London ruled he has the right to make another appeal. He's facing a trial in the U.S. after publishing highly classified material on his website. If he's convicted, he could spend the rest of his life in prison. Well, back at home, Minneapolis police are investigating two shootings that happened within 20 minutes of each other. One left a toddler with serious injuries. The first incident happened just before 9:30 last night on Cedar Avenue South. After a preliminary investigation, officers say a man walked up to a car and shot inside. A toddler was hit in the face. Police say the child's mom was also hurt, but was able to drive to the hospital. Then on 16th Avenue South, police say a man in his 30s was shot inside of a house. He is now at the hospital. Police say the two shootings are unrelated. The Minnesota BCA now has a new unit with a goal to keep the community safer. The Violent Crime Reduction Unit will focus on targeting what the BCA calls the drivers of local crime, like guns, drugs, and highly wanted criminals. The goal is to work with community partners.